Right, one take and go. We are not using a mic today because I can't be bloody bothered. I cannot be arsed. So it's just, I am just using my camera mic. So if it sounds a bit worse, or maybe even better, maybe the camera mic is the best thing in the world. But who knows. Doing something a bit different today. Fed up with the Wii. Probably will play it someday in the future, but get a bit fed up with that. What did we do the other day? Was it wrestling? Fed up a bit with that. What else did we film? We filmed something else the other day. And I can't remember what it was. I should know, but I can't remember. Was it unboxing or something like that? Fed up with that as well. Some of you, well, the five people that watch this channel that ain't my mates, will know that I like wrestling. Like the Wii and gaming. Also like football, but I haven't really put that much on the channel. That is also another thing I quite like, and that is Eurovision. Ooh, what's Eurovision? Eurovision is a song contest between all the European countries and Australia. Well, if you go by that logic, and Israel as well, because that's not in Europe, but, you know. We won't delve into that. Eurovision is a song contest between majority of the countries in Europe, and they all have a sing-song, and there's one winner at the end, and the winner hosts the next Eurovision. And I really like it, because it's just fun. It's fun, isn't it? Loads of fun and games. And I was going to do a video, you know, like the generic, ooh, here's my top favourite Eurovision songs from the 2021 Eurovision, where I was going to list them all, but I thought, that's going to take a lot of effort, because if you've watched the videos on the channel, you probably haven't, but there is like wrestling videos on there of just random theme songs. That takes a lot of time. It takes longer than the Wii videos. It takes longer than all the other videos, because you've got to clip the... Got to download the MP3 and then clip them all up, and it takes fucking ages. So what I've decided to do is just do a top five. A top five of my favourite songs, and it's not going to be the caramel diamond, I mean, that's going to be quick. And it's not going to be just a generic, you know, listing all the songs off. I'm going to have a little chat about them as well. You know, so strap in. This was really tough, because these five songs, I think, are all unique, and I do like them all individually, but... I have to wait and see, eh? Number five was quite tough because I've got two, maybe even three that could go in fifth. You know, fifth is still great. There's still loads of other songs that are behind you. But yeah, fifth I'm going to go for The Roop. The Roop. Batman, that's disgusting. The Roop is a Lithuanian act. That from last year. Unfortunately, last year didn't go ahead. He made a song. What was the song called last year? Was it On Fire? That was a banger, that was sick. I pitched that to win last year, and obviously didn't go ahead, so we don't know. And he's made a song this year called Discotheque, which is another brilliant song, and I think it'll, you know, go really well on stage as well, because it's like dancey and all that. Eurovision's not just about songs, it's about the staging as well. So, yeah, that is my number five. I'll insert, at the end of me talking about it, insert a little bit of a snippet of the song. Probably a copyrighted, but who cares? These videos don't get any views anyway. Not making money from this. Yeah, so number five is The Roop, Discotheque. Let's discotheque right at my home. It's okay to dance alone. It's a banger, and I think you'll like it, because it's just a fun song. And props to Lithuania, because in 2019, I really liked Run with the Lions. Although it didn't get past the semi-finals. I think that was a great song. Run with the Lions, and big ups to Lithuania. Would like to go to Lithuania, actually. Flights from Bristol to Cannes are quite cheap as well, but see that in the future, when COVID's all over. Fourth. I'm not sure on fourth. It's between two. And you know what, I'm going to go for Montaigne. Is it I'm reading it off a script here, because I had to write it down, because I forgot. Is it Montaigne? Montaigne, I'm going to go for. It's called Technicolor, and she is a Australian act. Ever since Australia got, was it 2015 that Australia got entered for the first time? I think all of the songs have been pretty good. Montaigne was going to enter last year, and was it called Break Me? And I really like that as well. It would be really interesting if Australia won. So I'm not entirely sure what happens if Australia win, because... You know, the winning country hosts it, and then it wouldn't really be Eurovision, then, would it? It would be in Australia. I think Australia nominate a country. I think I read that somewhere. I might be completely wrong. But I think Australia nominate somewhere. Do you know what we're going to nominate? Andorra. Oh, no, lovely. No, I don't know. But yeah, Technical is a brilliant song. Technical is really, really good. I think it could be up there. It could be right up there. Dami Im was the last person that done really well for Australia. I think he finished second, 2016. Jamala won it that year, didn't she? Ukraine. But yeah, Technical is a great song. I think it could be a hit in the charts as well. I know Eurovision is not really a charty thing. Duncan Lawrence is in the charts back again with Arcade. He won in 2019, Netherlands. It's in Rotterdam this year, Eurovision 2021. It's supposed to be in Rotterdam last year, and it's in Rotterdam this year because it didn't happen last year. But yeah, fourth is Montaigne. I'm going to say Montaigne. It's probably Montaigne. And it's Technicolor. Third, I'm going for Go A and Shum. It's a Ukrainian act. Again, Go A was going to enter last year with Solyove. I think it's called Solyove. I don't speak Cyrillic. I wish I could. It'd be great. But yeah, Go A is a really funny song. It really makes me laugh. But then again, I think it'll really bang. It'll really bang at Eurovision because the moves, the dancing and all that, I think will be great. I mean, I really like Solyove as well. I think Go A, Shum is better than Solyove, but still, this song will be so good at Eurovision. You watch After All, so you want to go past semi-finals, but I think the jury will love it, the public will love it. Oh, I think it'll do brilliant. I think it will do brilliant. And it'll, because Eurovision didn't, Ukraine didn't enter in 2019. They were going to, but they had like political problems, like Ukraine wasn't going to pay for it. Something to do with Russia and bollocks like that. I don't care. Which is quite disappointing. It would have been nice to see Ukraine enter, but you didn't. But yeah, Go A Shum. This song will probably make other people laugh, but it's also a banger. It's also a banger. I think it'll definitely be up there. But yeah, Go A Shum. The top two. At second place, it was very tough because I love this song. I listen to it constantly, and I'm a bit worried it's going to get a bit too much for me. But I'm still going to listen to it constantly. It is a Blind Channel, and what's it called? Dark Side. didn't like the song anymore. You love it so much, you don't even know the name. Yeah, it's a Blind Channel, Dark Side, and they're an act from Finland. Last year it was Axel Kakataranka, I think. I don't quite like that song, but this song's better. I'm not really that into rock and like heavy metal. It's not really heavy metal, but it's sort of rocky tune. I don't really listen to that on the daily. I'm more of like a dance EDM type of person. But yeah, this song is brilliant. It is so good. It's a bit like, was it Soft Engine? That Finland song, that was great. That was so good. They really do the rock songs good. Like, Hallelujah 2006, that was called. They won it that year. But yeah, this one will do really well, I think. In 2019, didn't really do that well. It was Darude, who made Darude Sandstorm. It is that one. He didn't do really well. I mean, the song was alright, but it was a good song, like, sort of on YouTube and that. It didn't really do well on stage, in my opinion. And it didn't get past semi-finals. But yeah, I think Blind Channel will do really well. I think it'd be quite an underrated one. Because I love it. I bloody love it. But it could be another one of them ones that's like everyone loves. A bit like Spain in 2019. We should have won, by the way. Spain should have won that year. Spain was so good. It'll be another one of them that everyone's like, oh yeah, this is great. And then it just doesn't do that well. Which is really disappointing. But yeah, if it does win, I won't have any quibbles. Because I love it. I absolutely love it. Blind Channel, Dark Side is in at number two. Put your middle fingers out, take a shot, join up and don't stop. Right, number one, switch the paper around so I can. I did have to translate this because I thought, ooh, maybe what if I pronounce it wrong? It is Daddy Freyja. I think it's Daddy Freyja. 10 years from Iceland. Who doesn't love a 6'9" Icelandic bloke with a brilliant voice. Yeah, last year he had... I can't remember the name of the song. He was going into last year, and that was... that with the Roop on Fire and that, that was my top two last year. Sorry about that. It, brilliant last year, brilliant this year. The dancing is brilliant. Brilliant voice. He's so likeable. The tunes, it's such a tune. It's just such a... One of them ones that's just such a tune. It'll get everyone going in the arena. Oh, speaking of arenas, I'd love to go and watch you one year. If I can afford it, I will. But, yeah. Number one is Daddy Freya, 10 years. I don't know what else to say. It's just brilliant, isn't it? And I think that will definitely be number one. Iceland never won it before. I don't think they have. Which will be really good to see an Icelandic winner. That'll be fantastic. But yeah, I'm going to look on my phone. My phone is light in my face. So. What was the song called last year? Oh, for fuck's sake. Sorry about this. Think About Things. That's what it's called. They've gone for the same outfits as well, the jumpers. I'd love to get one of them. Brilliant. But yeah, 10 years is it as good as the one last year? Maybe not, but I think it's still brilliant and I think it will definitely win. So Daddy Freya, it is Daddy. It's got that weird like D thing with like the cross at the top. It's just Daddy. It's how it looks. Yeah, Daddy Freya 10 years is my number one. So, thank you for watching Eurovision 2021 in May, which will be brilliant. Hopefully they have fans there, because I know in the Netherlands they were kicking off about the lockdown stuff, weren't they? They were like rioting and all bollocks like that, but hopefully it's over by then. And they can have fans in attendance, because I think Eurovision would be rubbish without fans. I mean, I watch wrestling, and that's rubbish without fans, but I mean, AEW is great, because it's got fans, but yeah, Eurovision without fans would be awful. I mean, it should be Graham Norton in the crowd. Can we just get Graham Norton? I don't know. Just Graham Norton on his own with no one in the background and stuff. But, yeah, I'll go through the list again. We've got... I can't remember. I think we went for the Roop Discotheque, Montaigne Technicolor, Go A Shoom, Blind Channel... Blind Channel Darkness. Is it Darkness? Oh, I don't know. Anyway, it's Blind Channel, number two, the Finland one, and number one is Daddy Freya, 10 years. So that is my top five. If you disagree, please let me know. If you do agree, that would be great. Please leave a like, subscribe, and all that bollocks. But yeah, Eurovision is great, and I wish I could watch it with my friends, but they're probably not really into it. I need to find someone that's into Eurovision, because if they are, we can watch it. Because it's on YouTube, isn't it? The Eurovision Songcast is always on YouTube every year. And the BBC, so you can watch it for free anyway. If you pay a TV licence, but bollocks at TV licence. Yeah, if someone does really like Eurovision and wants to watch it with me, just be a chill session, won't it? A little bit of a chill. We can watch it with Discord and watch YouTube, Eurovision. Yeah, thank you for watching. Cheerio. Fill me out with a flame. I will let you